Good morning, children. How are you? See, children, in our last session, we have completed almost one third of the lesson, 3/4 of the lesson. Today, we are going to read 1/4 remaining lesson. Then, we will discuss about the exercises given to you in this chapter. Okay, children, what we have learned regarding this story, A pig is a boy who was living with his sister and sister's husband. What is the name of sister's husband? Joe. Joe was working in a blacksmith. He was working in a forge, and he has the tools with him. One day, I escaped the prisoner when Pip was working in the graveyard as his sister ordered him to do so. When his sister ordered him to clean the graveyard, he reached the graveyard. He was crying a lot. He was feeling very sad. Suddenly, a pig person appeared in front of him. He thought that may be the devil. But when he saw at him, there was a ring around his leg, and there was a long chain tied to the ring, and there was a huge ball which was tied to that ring, and the man was walking very uncomfortably with a heavy luggage on his leg. So the man ordered Pip to bring some food as well as the tool to cut the iron ring. So he decided to take. That night he steal the food and the tool from his sister's house. If next morning he decided to go there. I stole the file, and I stole the bread and cheese, and I stole, since Mrs. Joe would go wild anyway, the big brown once a year at Christmas pig. Pea is a baked dish of meat, Nana. That also this boy took and went outside. I thought he would enjoy if it was still there in the morning. He was thinking it was the whole night he was spending in the graveyard. If anybody cock comes and catches him, if he is there, he will enjoy the food given by the pig. Now see, he was still there, colder, shaking with cold, hungrier, shaking with that. Now, that whole night, the prisoner did not eat anything. So, he was very hungry. The prisoner was very hungry. I asked him, and he told me, "Thank you, my boy." What he told, "Thank you, my boy," he said. When Pip offered the food to him, he said, "Thank you." And he asked my name. And when this boy gave the food to the prisoner, prisoner asked the name. He told Pip. Then I left because I was afraid to spend any more time away. "Give me the file, boy." Now he was asking about the file. File is a tool used to cut the sharp objects. Then I left because he don't want to spend more time outside. So he gave food, and when he was to leave the graveyard, the prisoner asked about the file. That was the last thing he said to me. He didn't say goodbye. When he was moving from the graveyard, he didn't say goodbye also. He didn't watch me go. He was falling away at his iron ring. Now he was busy in cutting the iron ring. Now he was like the savage dog at the farm. I was sorry for him, and I was terrified of him. I would never have dared unchain him. I left the prisoner unchaining himself, and I went back to the forge. Now Pig was, as he was a very small pig, he was very much afraid of the prisoner, how to unchain him. Even though he wanted to unchain him, because of his careness, bhai padatam valla atanki em sahayam cheyalapoyadu, food ichadu, or the tool he handed to him, and again he don't want to help him to cut the ring because he was very scared. He was very scared. So Pip left from that place. So Pip left from that place. Now see, children, Later that day I learned his name Mankiewicz. Now after one day completed and a people came to know about the name of the prisoner as Mankiewicz. About Mankiewicz. Mankiewicz. M pera and telisindi Mankiewicz and telisindi. Okay. Soldiers came hunting for Mankiewicz all over the maps. Mrs. Joe instantly blamed him for the loss of the pig. Mankiewicz must have stolen it. Poor fellow, said kind Joe. I didn't say anything. Now, next one day after, cops came there near to their house to search for the escaped prisoner. And the prisoner name was Mankiewicz. As pig stolen the food from the kitchen, his sister was thinking that this prisoner may have stolen the food from the kitchen. And Joe was saying, poor fellow, he may not have food. See Nana, how this small boy helped the prisoner who escaped from a prison, even though he don't want to do, but he helped. Ante manam jail lo nunchi parigettina vaadiki sahayam cheyamani nenu cheppanunnana. కానీ ఎవరైనా ఎవరికైనా మనం చేయగలిగిన హెల్ప్ చేయాలి. ఇఫ్ వీ క్యాన్ హెల్ప్ ఎనీబడీ, ఇఫ్ పాసిబుల్ టు హెల్ప్, వీ హ్యావ్ టు డూ ఇట్. అది మన చేతుల్లో ఉంటే చేయగలగాలి, లేదంటే వదిలేయాలి. ఓకేనా? సో ఫ్యూ ఆఫ్ ద ట్రూ ఆర్ ఫాల్స్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ గివెన్ టు యూ నానా ఇన్ దిస్ చాప్టర్. పిప్ గేవ్ మ్యాగ్విచ్ ఎ ఫైల్. ఎస్, హీ గేవ్ అ టూల్. Pip ate Mrs. Joe's pig. Pip tinnada nana piece of meat? No. First one children, true nana page number 58. True false I am reading. First one true nana, second one false. Coming to the third one nana, Pip had a key to unlock the prisoner. No. Pip didn't have any key. Pip didn't have any key. Coming to the fourth one children, Pip liked the dog at the farm. Yes, Pip liked the dog very much. Coming to the fifth one children, Mankiewicz found some bread in Pip's pocket. Yes, at first time when he met the pig in the graveyard, he took a piece of bread from the pig's pocket. We have learned in our last session. Mankiewicz was frightened of Pip. No, Pip was frightened of Mankiewicz. Coming to the next one children, Mankiewicz stole the pipe. No, he did not. Coming to the next one children, Joe felt sorry for Mankiewicz. Yes, Joe felt sorry for Mankiewicz. And down the right or wrong, Nana, they have given you, read the lines from the story and answer the question. Stop your nose. This is the dialogue written. Stop your nose. If you remember who said these words, Nana, who made the noise? What noise was it? As Pip was crying in the graveyard, Nana, nose was also blowing. Where was he at that moment? Why? He was at the graveyard to clean the graves. What were the two things that the speaker asked him for? Food and fire. The escaped prisoner asked for food and fire. Do you know what a fire is? Who asked this question to Pip? Now, next dialogue. Do you know what a fire is? What a fire is? The question I'm writing here, when the prisoner asked the pig to bring and food and fire, he asked that what is a fire? Do you know what is a fire? Prisoner asked. Mankiewicz asked. Did pig know what a fire was? How did he know? Yes, he know about the fire because his sister's husband was working with a force. He was using many tools which are used to cut the sharp objects and the iron objects. Okay, what food did Pip bring for the speaker? Christmas pig. opposite. Let me tell you one again. Synonym means meaning, same meaning. And antonym means opposite. Opposite. You know very well about these two terms. Now what they have given you, Nana? They have given you few words, Nana, and they gave few words in the bracket to find out the correct synonym for the given word. See, children. From the lesson itself, they have given you these words. From the lesson itself, they have given you the name. See, these are the words given to you, Nana. And they have given you, children, few more words in the bracket, and they told us to write the correct meaning. What they have given you in the bracket, if you see, children. First one, hungry. And they have given cheap. They have given hard. They have given you wet. They have given you afraid, and they have given you friendly. Okay, next they have given you kind. They have given you happy. So these are the words given to you, children, and you have to find out the correct synonym from the words given to you. Okay, difficult. Difficult అంటే నా వెరీ హార్డ్ ముందు వచ్చి చేసేద్దాం ఈజీగా డిఫికల్ట్ మీన్స్ వెరీ హార్డ్ ఓకే ఇన్ ఎక్స్పెన్సివ్ ఎక్స్పెన్సివ్ ఇన్ ఎక్స్పెన్సివ్ అంటే ఎక్స్పెన్సివ్ చీప్ ఇన్ ఎక్స్పెన్సివ్ అంటే చీప్ ఓకే నెక్స్ట్ లవ్వింగ్ లవ్వింగ్ మీన్స్ కైండ్ వెరీ కైండ్ ఓకే నా charming, delighted, delighted and happy. Okay, delighted. And easy one I am doing first. You also have to do in the same way. Okay, when you are writing anything in the exam or anywhere, first go for the easy ones. Okay, sure answers mundu pettali ikkadaina. Okay, Nana, next Nana, coming to our next one, frightened, soaking, charming, ravenous. Ravenous, hungry. We have learned in the story. He is hungry. Soaking and they pinch kovadam. Wet. Frightened and they afraid. Bhayapadadam. Afraid. And charming. What is left with you, Nana? Friendly is left with you. We have given you 8 meanings and 8 words I have written here. See, children. Soaking meaning wet. Frightened meaning afraid. Loving meaning kind, not mean. Kind. Difficult meaning hard. And ravenous, hungry. Delighted, happy. Charming, friendly. Inexpensive, cheap. Cheap. Now these are the synonyms we are writing. We wrote all these synonyms. Now children, same way they have given us the pair of the opposites and they have told us to match. They did not give in this way. They have given you two columns and they told us to write the opposites. It's very interesting, children. Let us see the opposites also before to conclude our today class. Then tomorrow we will discuss the grammar exercises related to the topic. See, Nana, what they have given. They have written first one for us. Last, first, Meera 7. Then they have given dash. 1, 2, 3 dashes they have given. Next they have rich food. Okay, rich food they have given you. And again they have given 3 more dash. 3 more blanks. Adjectives. How we can frame the degrees of adjectives? Okay, children, bye.